Let's install Hitman 2, guys. Hitman 2. Steelbook edition.
Still don't really know what the steelbooks are about.
In the disc goes. Where will it stop? Nobody knows? Hitman 2. And I've got Hitman 1, so it'll also get all that stuff. But version 1.8 is downloading. So, version 1 off the disc of Hitman 2 is 10 gigs, we'll call it, at 10 minutes. That's cool, a gig a minute. We also saw there was going to be version 1.00 on the disc. Version 1.08 update file preparing to download. Well, we're going to have to wait for that one to work out how big it is. Here we go. 28 minutes for 20 gigs. All right. So it's an extra 20 gigs, twice again over. And then the other question is, can we kick off what we own in the store? Because we've got the, whatchamacallit, legacy levels. So everything from Hitman 1, you know, into Hitman 2. So what I need to do here, I think, as well, is I'm going to select all, and that way it'll bring all the content of Hitman 1 into the Hitman 2 main menu, and I can play all that again. So disc install, patch for Hitman 2 install, and now I'm assuming it'll be a bunch of single level packs. Now, do I have to select all manually? Oh, look, some stuff's already installed. Gotta love that. All right, legacy stuff's installed. Awesome. Legacy suit, I should say. But Paris level. Sapenza? How little I know about other languages. Marrakesh. Bonus missions. Bangkok. Colorado. And the rest. Ah, no. I don't even want it. Hokkaido? Best guess. No idea. Apologies if my slaughtering pronunciation offends you. So, all that said, 8 minutes left on the disc install. And then in notification land, what do we got? Wow, that's blown out the main one by having the extra ones. There you go. Maximum of 3 concurrent downloads. Queued for download, queued for download. Bunch of levels. And that bad boy. So, 7-8 minutes. It looks like the quickest thing to install is going to be the disc. 8 minutes left. But we don't even want to launch that, really. It kind of doesn't matter. We don't really want to launch it until we've got all the extra content anyway. So how about we leave it on this here screen? As I said, Hitman 2, installing. Version 1 on the disc is 10 gigs. Version 1.08 patch is downloading now. It's call it 20 gigs. And then a bunch of the legacy levels. Who knows what this is going to stretch out into. We'll leave it rolling. Hey guys, me again. 10 seconds here, quickly. Let's have a look at the 1.8 install. It's at, what, 4.3 gig. Last time it looked like it cut off and then start. So there was 17. Doesn't look like it's going to happen now. I got all excited over nothing. I thought what happened last time, and I'd have to roll back the video to find this out, but I thought the first map that downloaded, once it finished, it went from a 20 gig install in the 1.08 patch, and then it sort of like went back to zero, and the 19 went to 17. So it like downloaded 2 gigs, like got part of the file. I'm assuming it comes down as a zip file. So it like got the first 2 gigs of a zip file and then reset, but trimmed off the total file size. And then restarted again. So I don't really know from a networking and architecture standpoint how they deploy these patches, but interesting nonetheless to know that if your internet fell out halfway through a patch download, it could resume. I mean, I guess that makes a lot of sense. That exists in torrent land. Like maybe it's a torrenting technology. Who knows? Not me. And I don't think that technology is called torrenting, is it? It's got some really fancy name. Regardless, the 1.08 patch continues. I'll be very interested to look back at the video and see what happened there entirely. But anyway, we've definitely got 2 levels so far. Yeah, those 2 levels are installed. So I've got 1, 2, 3 downloads in the queue and 3 active downloads. The more I think about this, the more it's the default configuration for torrent clients. 3 concurrent torrents, a queue, you close the computer, the internet shuts down, it like pauses. The only thing it doesn't do is recalculate the total file size. That's pretty wild that that happened. At least I think it happened. I'd have to go back and watch the video. Anyway, this is all working again now. We're in pretty good stead. It's saying 58 minutes, so that's pretty good. But once again, I suspect once it finishes these 3 levels, that 58 minutes will reevaluate, assuming we get all 3 levels done. My point is, when it gets to 1 download, I think it's faster than having 3 concurrents. Like the total aggregate bandwidth probably never changes, but it maybe it evenly distributes them amongst, like it divides it by 3, if you're with me, because there's 3 concurrent downloads. Who knows? We'll just see what happens. But anyway, we'll leave that rocking and rolling. That's there. You're there. Don't go anywhere. This is riveting. If you're watching live, I should say, twitch.tv/geekaloud. You could join in the chat live if you wanted to. And, you know, every time it finishes one part of the download, you could cheer. I don't know. Whatever floats your boat. Alternatively, of course, you're watching this after the fact and you're watching it on youtube.com/geekaloud. The benefit of watching it after it's been recorded is you can like scroll back as I talk about something and re-watch a section of the, you know, loading spinner, install bar, progress bar, call it what you will. Anyway, I'm going to leave this right here. It's going to keep rocking and rolling. I'll jump in as crazy things happen. All right, guys, enjoy. All right, guys, little update here. What do we got? 23 minutes left on the main patch download. Getting there on the levels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of the legacy levels installed. 2 currently happening. The last one. Interesting how much they fluctuate in size. They can sort of be anywhere from 4 gig, and I think this 8 gig one's the most, so like some levels are twice the size. Good for them. Guess there's a bit more going on. So yeah, 23 more minutes. We should, in theory, get all 3 maps installed right about the time the main patch is finishing. I don't know why this excites me, but the idea of the whole game being ready at the same time is quite enjoyable. All right, anyway, I'll leave it rocking and rolling. We're getting there, getting close, getting exciting. Alright, now that the all the levels have finished downloading, I'm expecting this last little bit here to really take off and finish quickly. We shall see what happens. I don't know if you noticed, but the once that third download dropped off, the other two sped up, and now it's the top one by itself, so it'll just eat up that bandwidth. Alright, final stretch here. If you're watching along live on twitch.tv/geekaloud, I appreciate you, good work. Or alternatively, you're watching this later, youtube.com/geekaloud. I also appreciate you guys. Alright, we're all done. I believe we can jump in from here. We can, let's go. So that was disk install, 1.08 patch install, and all the legacy levels, because hey, PlayStation Plus gave us Hitman 1 this week. So then we're able to get all the legacy levels into Hitman. I'd call that a successful install, off it goes. Warner Brother Games. I did not know they published this. There you have it. Alright. IO Interactive. Kinda looks like 101. Kinda dig that, you know, computers. Everything's a ones and zeros. It's great. All right. Play online. There's a tip for the full experience. Play online. All right, guys. That's it. Fully installed and ready to go. What were we? An hour and a half, give or take. Fantastic stuff. Obviously, there'll be a Let's Play of Hitman 2 coming shortly. That was the install. There's also a bunch of other installs all together for you in one playlist on YouTube. Go back, watch the highlights. There's a lot of them. That's all for this install, guys. Thank you very much. Remember, gameplay, live gameplays every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday night. So obviously today's Tuesday. There'll be one in a few hours. Thanks, guys. Catch you then.